another verse.
Greetings, I'm Shad, and as you might be aware on this channel, we like to review the medieval aspects, the medieval-like weapons, you know, so melee weapons, but also warfare in movies, how it's adapted into movies, okay? So I've done it multiple times with classic medieval kind of movies. You did the King and then Outlaw King, and further back, we look at fight scenes or fight scene autopsy, but also just battlefield tactics as well. Mulan, the fight scene autopsy on Mulan, where we go into the an autopsy on the battlefield tactics. Well, that was a lot of fun because, wow, that film. But so in this episode, we are looking at a special one. This one has been on my radar for a while, okay? Because clips of this battle were shared on Facebook, right? And I've seen some of them, and it's amazing, okay? This is where you get into the realm of such campy, goofy, over-the-top ridiculousness that, you know, obviously it was done for purpose, on purpose. There was no doubt this was on purpose, and it's for fun. And this is the part where I'm fully on board with it. I love it. I think this is great. Absolutely, there should be a place for just over-the-top ridiculousness. Where this doesn't work is when there's a movie trying to be somewhat grounded and realistic, and then they do something just so out of left field dumb and takes you out of the film. But then there are action films that they lean into it and just embrace it, and they want everything over the top, and it's just for fun. And you know it's for fun, so you're not taking it seriously in the beginning, and you're just watching the spectacle. This film definitely falls into that. Some other examples that fall into this category. Final Fantasy Advent Children. Look at the fight scenes. It's just ridiculous, over the top people throwing motorbikes, jumping 100 feet in the air, doing crazy things, wielding swords that realistically they wouldn't be able to lift. Or with super strength they would, but they'll still top a lot. I've got a video on it, okay, about it. You need weight, not necessarily strength. Anyway, so that's another topic. But so the over-the-top stuff is fun, and sometimes it's even fun to analyze the stupidity over-the-top things just for the sake of, all right, this is what we're doing. And maybe we'll do that in some of this. So we're going to be looking at what might be possible, what definitely won't be, some of the stupid, and also just a laugh along with it. So what is this film? I've been building it up, all right? And you might have heard Oz, if we allow his racist tirades to into this thing. Well, look, he's not. I'm just teasing him, okay?
My friend, what is racist about it?
It's an Indian film. Now, just on a so it's an Indian film called Baahubali. Baahubali? I think that's Baahubali.
My friend.
All right, that's enough of the accent. You don't need to do the whole thing.
Do the whole thing?
No, you're not.
Every time.
Baahubali, okay? This is just over-the-top fun. Now, a couple of notes, right? For some reason, I don't know why, but it's in line with certain... look, hear me out, okay? This is actually a compliment. It's in line with certain aspects that I've seen out of India's culture. Because when you look at some of the weapons that they've developed historically, some of them are crazy ridiculous over-the-top things. Like, they just have this, I don't know, aspects that they like exploring the wacky things and go as far as possible. And sometimes it can work out and create something mildly functional, like the pata, the gauntlet sword. Then other times it can create something just stupid off the face of it, like the whip sword. Like, it's just... Yes, it's a sword made out of such thin spring steel that it's really flexible, and they whip it around, and I might have to do a dedicated video on why that's just a dumb weapon. But they do it, and they got like all over the top. Now, India has a really impressive history in terms of their technological progress. If you go back, they were some of the first people ever that were making good quality steel, okay? And that before the birth of Christ, we're talking about 1,000 years BC almost, they're making crucible steel. This is incredible.
Yes, but we were last people to invent toilet, my friend.
All right, that's it. That's the end, okay? And look, I'm actually, I think when we look at other cultures and everything, celebrate the things that are worth complimenting, celebrating, but it doesn't mean any culture is beyond criticism. There are things that, you know, we shouldn't give a free pass in any culture for doing bad things in the past, present, but we're not really talking about those things. We're talking about a fun over-the-top film, which is somewhat in line with, I don't know, India's kind of perspective sometimes of how they like to approach things. And there are some crazy, ridiculous films India has made, but this is very much in the epic battle. This is like one of those epic warfare movies that they made. It's called Baahubali. Let's dive into it and watch some of this. And we're going to be watching some of the battle scenes from the first movie, and there's a second one. There's one in particular in the second one that we must watch. So something like this, it's actually pretty grounded. I mean, yeah, the techniques aren't great, but I've seen far worse in many other films. Oh, there's a guy checking out. I mean, I can appreciate it. Check it out. Check it out. A good-looking woman kicking butt with a sword. You know? I can appreciate this. So I have no idea what's going on. I actually haven't watched the full film, but I kind of want to. The problem is I don't like subtitles. I'm lazy. You know, this is like a training scene. Again, I have no idea what's going on. I'm liking the music already. But we might get copyright struck for the music, so we'll tow that down. But one of the things I kind of notice about this, right? And this is how you do it. This is how you do over-the-top things. The actors are playing it straight, all right? They're actually trying to make it so that in character that they're all reacting really genuinely to this ridiculous stuff. And, I mean, look at this. Let strong, manly men be manly. Let's just lean into the stereotypical manly hero stuff. And look at it. Look at that guy. He's got a mustache. That's like... I love it. I don't know what on earth is going on, but... Some type of training thing showing he's very strong. He's a strong man. We're going to be seeing this guy in some of the battles. Just to show some of the like earnest acting kind of things where they're all playing it straight. They're all very serious about it. And so I kind of like that, where they're doing these ridiculous over-the-top things, but the actors are just pretending it's all par and course of just the normal stuff.
My friend, Bollywood is no laughing matter, okay?
So, they're preparing for the battle. Like, look at the armor. What?
The first casualty. Here he comes.
It's just, you know, fantasy over-the-top armor and stuff, and leaning into it. It's great. We'll skip forward a bit. Their rousing speech of some kind gives me the vibes of the Rohan speech from Lord of the Rings. And again, it's like playing it straight. They're just fully into it. Look at that face. Did you see that expression, right? And so now they're being attacked by, I think the most appropriate way to name this army, the army we're looking at, is the Great Army of Blackface. It is though.
Yeah, yeah. Let's look. Can you call it with the
racial? Well, this one's in your face, and it's pretty plain.
I didn't notice that.
You didn't. You didn't know. Well, look. It gets far more pronounced a bit later on. But
clearly, they're meant to represent Pakistan, the mortal enemy.
They were one country once. You know, Gandhi, he had the right idea, but he just couldn't. They didn't listen to him, and they wanted to split apart. So, anyway, the barbarian horde is at the gates. sorry, I wanted to watch this guy's face. No, hang on, keep going. How far does this skip? This is going about like a minute. Sorry, it's just, that guy's leaning into it. Ready? This might be one of the greatest movies ever made, and I haven't even watched it, and I'm saying it.
No, what you said before, when this looks like Indian Rohirrim,
mm-hmm.
A Bollywood Lord of the Rings would be the greatest movie ever.
And this is kind of it. I think, like, when you the scale of this battle that we're about to comment on, we're not going to watch the whole thing, just key parts and things, but, oh my goodness. Right. And when I'd be saying and hemming up that there's some ridiculous things happens in this battle. I'm not sure you understand just how ridiculous it gets. We're going to see some amazing things here. Barbarian horde, or like they're, you know,
Did they kill King Kong?
What creature was that? This part is great. So I've seen this on Facebook, but I got to share it with you guys. So catapults. First off, these types of catapults, look, I'm just saying it, didn't exist historically. Oh, look, they were smaller Onaga type things, but on this scale, they are trebuchets. And in actual fact, the catapult was actually used as a word to describe trebuchets even in medieval texts and things.
Well, trebuchet can throw a 90 kilogram projectile 300 meters.
I have heard, you know, that is accurate, but that's kind of, they're always referencing Warwolf. A lot of trebuchets are much smaller.
Can.
But no, well, not most trebuchets can't do that. That's the thing, is only the biggest of the trebuchets can. So, hang on. We need to, so they have, see these arrow things that they're putting in? All right. I haven't researched in depth about these things. I don't know if this is historical, just over the, where someone saw a picture in something and just thought definitely they were used, because I just don't think they'll work not nearly as well as they show here. Because see how the concept is that they're putting these arrows in these things, and there's a flat plate on a spring type or weighted thing they're going to slap in. The problem with that, and look, yes, we will break down the ridiculous stuff in, because it's just fun to get, like, talk about and break down things like this. The problem with that, the arrows on the bottom of it, right, will get hit with a vastly less force and less speed from this slapping motion because of the angular momentum compared to the arrows that at the top. So the top might actually punch or hit things, but the other problem is when they get hit, it's no gradual build-up. Like, even with a bow, there is a gradual build-up. The string starts at zero, the arrow is there, notched at it, starts at zero, and then speeds up. There's an acceleration, where this is hitting with full force at the top, and that'll just make the arrow bend and probably snap. It's very unlikely that that would actually cause it to shoot off.
Also, think about 100-pound bow, right?
Mm-hmm.
One single bow doing 100 pounds on one arrow.
Yep.
There's, like, over 100 arrows, mm-hmm. which means you're going to need to have 100 times
yeah,
the force.
Yeah, yeah. This, it's ridiculous. It just wouldn't work. And then the arrows on the bottom will basically just get and barely even go out. But it's going to pretend that, like, this is an insane, I don't know, Gatling gun barrage stuff. Because it's ridiculous. That's the point of the film. And I know the film is aware that, especially with the level that they push things to, none of this stuff would work in real life, ever.
I think you're wrong, Shad. This isn't the Rohirrim. This is Battle of Five Armies.
Battle of Five Armies.
This isn't India. It's the Battle of the Fiver Armies.
That was an epic shield wall that we just saw then. Like, look at this.
That's actually cool.
That is cool. There is, like, this is ridiculous, but it's all for the cool factor. That's why it's great. You can absolutely do over-the-top unrealistic things for the cool factor. And I think you can even get away with it in more grounded, realistic things if you can really sell it and justify it. And so it kind of depends. All right, I'm pausing here. Are you not going to tell me this is not the army of blackface? Look at that!
You can't actually get extras from Pakistan to start war.
I kind of respect this, not because I think you should or shouldn't. It's just that in the modern climate, which, like, Western movie studio would ever have an entire army of antagonists that are black? No one would, like, it's so politically charged, no one would have the balls to do it.
Well, you know...
And for me, this is the reality. I don't care, and it doesn't matter. It depends what's justified in the story, okay? They can be black, white, yellow, green, blue, doesn't matter, all right? Because it's a fictional world. It shouldn't even reflect. I don't even know if they're trying to justify this based somewhat historically. But even if it was, right, there were cultures historically that obviously were made up of certain ethnicities that went to war against each other. And sometimes people portray the British as the villains or the French as the villains. Like Joan of Arc, if you ever see the Joan of Arc films, the English are always the a-holes and the bad guys. But if you ever see movies where it's like Battle of Agincourt, like the king, it's the British that are justified and the French that are a-holes. But no one cares because, I don't know, they're all white. Who cares who's the bad guys or the good guys? But if one has a certain ethnicity, then, oh, no, they have, like, the modern climate sucks, basically.
And it's not our fault.
But anyway, I just like that they don't care. I don't know when this movie was made. It's probably before a lot of the issues coming in. And sometimes people discover things like this in the past and they cry, you know, outrage and everything. I hope they don't go, One, I hope they don't go after it, but two, I think India just wouldn't care, so.
Yeah,
Indian. Yeah. Like, we don't care about your, you know, posturing moral outrage for virtue, yeah. So I just appreciate that at least in some places, people are just making movies to make cool movies, and they're not trying to make any social commentary or anything like that. And they needed an army that comes from a certain area, and oh, they're all going to be black, so I guess they wear black faces or something. They're not trying to make a statement. All right, so this is the part where we see the arrows. Look at these arrows just launch off. But what's I find hilarious about it, the approach of that panel is so slow. It's just like, but then the arrows just like, watch, ready? See how slow that is? And then they're out, and they're launched. The arrows fly down, but they had like a mix of just regular arrows, and one guy even got pinned to a tree. I'm not sure if you saw that. they have shields. They could have raised, one guy was just, he had a shield, and he was running like this with arrow fire coming to him. And see this guy? That is like an epic mustache.
Yeah.
And he knows it. So they're doing one of the classic, you know, like this is a cinematic trope of army engagements. They started charging how far away? Like a kilometer? I would, by this point, I'd be like, in armor with weapons, I'd be like, yes, we're gonna kill you. Just
curry is nutritionally dense, okay, and allows you to run for hours to carbohydrates in it.
But they did in Braveheart, what were they? Haggis.
Haggis,
yeah. You're right. What'd be better? Haggis or a haggis curry? So, yeah, just regular chat. See the straight face there? They play a straight. Now, this is, all right. Wow, I went back a while. So they're not even holding their shields up, but the straight face is like, no, do it. Now watch this, okay? One, look at how slowly that arm is moving. All right, in reality, right? If that was it, that was the rate of speed of the swirling arm, the ball would just go plonk. But look how far this thing launches. I criticized Game of Thrones The Long Night for their insane distance of their trebuchets. Like they shot over several kilometers almost in the Game of Thrones, which is just stupid. This one, the catapults cannot shoot nearly as far. And catapults like this, they didn't get nearly as big. The Romans might have used some types, but trebuchets actually came in much sooner. Traction trebuchets pulled by manpower came much sooner than people think. Even the early crusaders had them. Traction trebuchets I'm talking about. But anyway, so these things, they'd never be, like, when they get to that size, just the weight of the arm, and they're supposed to work off of rope tension, and anyway, but look how crazy far this thing gets shot. Yeah, that's so far, but you know why they just shot one? Like, they're measuring the distance and range, like, aha, they're in range now. So, watch what they do. This is glorious. I just love how serious they play it. It's great. What do you think? All right, have you seen this before, Oz?
No.
All right, tell me, what do you think they are doing?
I'm going to guess that maybe they're going to throw people. I don't know.
Well, look, that was a cinematic shot. You got to give it that. Well, what is their plan here? They're throwing cloth. This would just not work on so many levels. One, the distance is stupid. All right, that would create such insane drag. It would really actually affect those things. The other thing is the way that it lands. Watch how it lands, because it wouldn't land like this. But what do you think they're doing, Oz?
I don't know.
You don't know?
They're having a really intense game of cards.
And look how smoothly it lands. Right. If it landed like, if it actually landed like that, the cloth would just bunch up. The cloth would fall and bunch up. But it lands on them like a perfect blanket. Look at this. What's going on? What are they doing?
No cloth, my one weakness.
Wait for it. Tell me as soon as you realize what's going on.
Oh, yeah, it's soaked in oil and kerosene.
Yes, it is. It is. Like, oh no!
Man, what a waste of cashmere.
That would actually be expensive cloth, but holy crap! That thing goes a lot like it's napalm! It's stupid and it's hilarious and I love it.
Man, that's the thing, right? It's just so interesting that back in the day we didn't have the concept of war crimes. We should return to tradition.
And then they launched heaps. And it's great. It's great. All right, so we need to skip forward to some of the other parts. Because that won't stop the army of blackface. All right. That's an epic shield wall. That is just glorious. I love that the barbarian horde just jumps on the spears. Like, I don't know how intelligent these guys are, but okay, sure. This is, who's that guy in Futurama? His tactics were, he just threw, you know, the robots had a kill count, and so all I had to do was throw my men at it.
Captain Zach Brannigan?
Zach Brannigan?
He's actually a war hero.
It almost is like this strategy, because their strategy is just throw enough men at this shield wall to die, to pile up bodies enough to just walk over the bodies over the shield wall. That's their strategy.
It's good enough for the Imperial Guard, it's good enough for these Indians. Drown them in your blood.
And these guys don't even have a shield wall. Look at that! Look at his breastplate. That is that's epic. That's an epic breastplate. We're going back. We need to see. Just that's the type of thing you'd see in a Soul Calibur series. Look at it.
Oh, that's cool.
That is cool. Weird.
His breastplate has the same expression as him.
Yeah, but no one would complain about his breastplate when it's as practical as boob armor is. Which means, and by the way, boob armor can be fully practical. So.
Fun fact about this movie.
Oh, did you see that?
Yeah.
He threw his sheath at the enemy and is going sword and axe. It's great. I just love it. It's just flailing about, killing it one guy after another. It's beautiful. Okay. Did we see that? He gets a mace, like a ridiculously oversized mace, and then it disconnects into a flail and has some type of spring mechanism to pull it back in.
This is the greatest movie I've ever
seen. Isn't it awesome?
I've actually watched this.
And like, genuinely, it's amazing. Oh my goodness.
Yeah, return to sender.
Hang on, the guy, right, this guy, he headbutts a guy in a helmet and kills the guy in the helmet because he's just tough. Watch, wait for it. Ready, bang! Right through the armor, of course. Armor does nothing. And instead of the hair flick, it's the mail flick. You know, the whoosh.
Look at that.
Look at this guy. He's a hero. This guy is an epic hero. Just watch this movie with your friends and you'll just laugh your head off. This is amazing. That move right there, like, it's so dumb, but they can get away with it. Ready? It's like this weird stance. He holds it over his back. What is that? I have no idea, but they can get away with it because this movie, like, they know... It's ridiculous. Yet it's just so funny because they play it so serious and straight. And that's what makes it great. Look at that. I mean, unironically, I would love to see, like, the people who made this should make, I don't know, what's a classic property you'd love to see people adapt?
The Halo TV show.
The Halo TV show. I mean, it's too dumb for Lord of the Rings, yet they would still make something 1,000 times better than Amazon will. Guaranteed. Like, look at this. It's just the poses, the expressions, and it's dumb everywhere, yet I'm into it. It's great.
Dude, imagine if they did Indian Lord of the Rings. Walking to Pakistan.
It would be amazing. I would totally watch that. So this is like epic spear action. So, what do you notice about these spears, Oz?
They're double-sided.
They are double-sided spears.
I can't tell if that's genius or retarded.
No, I think there's validity to it. There are double-sided kind of spike spear type thing. But look at this, ready? Spike, then spin. A spike, a spin.
Because he needs a fresh blade.
And it knocks them aside. Instead of getting through them and getting stuck, they just get blown aside. Look at this. Watch this. Wait for it. Wait for it. Ready? Wait. Oh. And because India has more censorship about grotesque violence, it's just knocking them aside. It's not cutting them in half. It's amazing.
This is how the lawnmower was invented.
I love it. It's absolutely glorious. Oh. Oh, man.
This is one of the best movies I've ever seen.
Unironically, right? And part of it is because they just don't care. We're going to do awesome stuff. It's dumb, but it's going to look cool. And they just embrace it. And it's made one of the most incredible films ever. Look, this would not be a low budget thing though. Look at the amount of extras they have. The evil guys are about to do an evil thing. This reminds me of when, you know, the orcs throw the decapitated heads over the walls of Minas Tirith, right? It's got those vibes. This is like the Indian Lord of the Rings. Human shields. Ooh. Anyway, we'll skip forward to some of the other crazy stuff. Hang on. What is this? This is about as far as I just watched as a prep, and so I don't know what happens here. But they're like bowlers, except they're heavy metal. How far do they throw those things? And they throw it at their own people, so they all fall down. Oh, your human shield is gone. Would have just broken and snapped their legs, but sure. it's amazing. And look at that. The heroes, they save them. Man, there wasn't many cavalry there, and there was a lot of the barbarian horde, though. The horde could have easily just wiped out. But, you know, like I said. Hang on. We can see, like, an example of the black face really clearly here. Watch under his underarm, where some of the paint doesn't reach. It's hard not to notice, is all I'm saying, okay?
That looks like me in blackface.
Like, it's hard not to notice.
I have to say, I'm surprised he didn't catch the spear.
But then he catches it and pins him to a tree. A guy has three times his size almost. Oh, man. It's great.
I want the Indians to do Dark Souls.
You're right. That's the adaptation that you would be able to do awesomely. Dark Souls adaptation. Stabs the arrow into the guy. Just throw it like this is a full-size person, picks him up and turfs him. Like, but this is the thing, if you could lift some of the weapons that they have, like the ridiculous oversized weapons, you would be able to turf them. Like some of the swords in Elden Ring, if you can lift those swords, you could just pick up any person and turf them like a rag doll. Oh, shield bash on the edge, that was great.
Oh.
Oh, cute. Lost his arm. I'm still fighting. Look at this guy string someone up at the flag.
When they said hoist the colours,
you
know what they meant.
Yeah. Oh my goodness. This film is amazing. So look at this epic charge into like the spinning death blades. The metal ball is just knocking people into the sky. Oh, this seriously would have been really difficult to film. My goodness. That's a full green screen right there, though. But still, I love it. Oh, they broke through the first wave. he throws with one arm like a boulder, a catapult boulder. They don't need catapults, they got these guys. Just pick them up and throw them. Boss battle time? with a giant, ridiculous mace that can turn into a flail. And he just knocks an elephant off his feet.
That's literally a weapon in Elden Ring, and it's like the best one.
Okay, so this is actually the sequel. This is Baahubali. I don't know if I did a thing on the throat. Baahubali 2, and it has a moment in this, which is just, it's been shared on the internet. I have to show you guys. It is glorious. It is amazing. So it looks like they did not lose their stride at all into the second film. And it seems like the antagonist in this one might be another. It's not a barbarian horde. It's another kingdom. I haven't watched it. I think I must, just because how great it is. Now, the good guys seem to be attacking this city. It's a very big city of some kind. And look at the size, like, the epic scale of this is, like, on the scale of Lord of the Rings. Like, look at the size of this thing.
It's fine.
It's a flesh wound. It'll shrug it off. So, how are they going to do it? How are they going to get over this giant wall with a huge moat? And now they're getting arrows shot at the same time. The panel slap arrow things. Is he gonna get hit?
I love it when they do that in movies.
Like, oh, now there's a shield. Okay. I'm wondering if his lover was kidnapped behind that thing, because his. But all the good guys, they're getting slaughtered. What will they do? How will they get over this wall, Oz?
I have seen it.
You have seen this part? Yeah. It's incredible. It is incredible. So Oz knows. Nathan, do you know?
Yeah, no.
You know. This is just incredible. Probably like most of my viewers have seen this as well, but we just have to watch and appreciate it together. So, what will they do? What will they do? He screams to the sky. And then, hang on a second. What are they?
Palm trees.
Palm trees. He knows what to do.
Cut them down, process them into palm oil and sell it.
Yeah, maybe cut them down or... Hang on. What? Not what? No. What is this? I didn't know palm trees could bend that much. What's going on? Like, if you...
Fun fact, this is literally
the Indian space program. Like...
Indian
droidicas. And they land perfectly fine. The human catapult, and then just kicks his shield into them and they start just wrecking people. It is, like, glorious. Everyone else, they got the same idea, we'll do it as well! If this was such a defensive weakness, why did you leave the trees there? You should have chopped down the trees! How could you have predicted that they could be bent so much and be used as human catapults? And I love it, they land, they're perfectly fine. They're just, like... Boing. And then they just go on and continue to wreck everything. Oh, gee.
This is why China fears India.
Yeah. It is amazing. What just over-the-top, fun, stupid, crazy things. There's more coming. Oh, my goodness. Yeah. I really feel the best example of the stupid cool factor, where you just do things because you know it's dumb, but who cares? It's going to be fun and look awesome.
He just threw his shit like Captain America style. Yeah. Like Captain Singh Rajesh.
Oh man, you gotta love Bollywood sometimes. You really do. Like, I respect that they have the balls to do this, and they just don't care as well. They just we're gonna have fun with it. It is awesome. So, I don't know if you have access to the film. It's worth a watch. Oz wants to watch it. I really need to.
It's Is that Indian Zeus?
I don't know. But it is amazing. And unironically, this is the thing, like, I think this, as I mentioned, this ridiculous over-the-top fun action type of things would feel very out of place for a film like Lord of the Rings. Though, Legolas, they almost approach it in some instances. Like, what about when Legolas takes out the olifant?
Yeah.
It's almost on the same vein, isn't it?
Yeah.
But they try and sell it a little more. Like they're not launching people as catapults over the walls of Minas Tirith.
Well, I mean, they are. Just the top part.
Yeah. So, that level of just unbelievable stupidity, like ridiculousness, wouldn't fit Lord of the Rings.
Lord of the Rings? The bloody... Okay, sure, the orcs throw human heads over with catapults, mm-hmm. but in response, the people of Minas Tirith throw entire buildings with catapults.
Bits of broken buildings.
Like... walls, etc.
They needed stone. That can be passed, right? But what I'm saying, there are some other properties where this style, I think, would fit perfectly fine. But there is a line, don't you think, where one way they're trying to sell some believability, and like that, the human catapult tree thing, that's beyond the line, don't you think?
Indians trying to sell something under... No, that doesn't.
No, that would never happen. They would never try and sell stuff that you just would never buy. But there we go. Look, all right, let us know in the comments properties that haven't been adapted into live action that you think this style of over-the-top things could suit. Because some do suit, like Final Fantasy Advent Children. That's a good example of just stupid fun. Okay, I'd love to see some thoughts in the comments below what you think would suit.
A movie that we should check out because it's similar to this, yeah. Red Cliff. It's a Chinese movie.
I've heard of it.
It's very good.
But it is, I thought it was more serious battle war movie.
No, like, it's not as campy as this,
yeah.
but it still has the over the top, like, there's, you know, thousands of regular soldiers and there's the one dude who's like, just like a Marvel superhero.
All right, well, it's like Lord of the Rings then a bit.
Yeah,
you know when Gimli and Aragorn just like, you have to toss me, and then they land on the bridge and they just hold off the Uruk-hai army on the bridge, the two of them.
Yeah, it's not as over the top as this, mm-hmm. It's very high production quality. It's a very good movie. Yeah.
All right, we might have to check that out, definitely. Thank you guys for watching. I hope to see you on the next video here on Shadowversity. So until that time, farewell.